हेलो स्टूडेंट, अंडर द चैप्टर हीट अ फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी आर टूडेज टॉपिक इज फ्लो ऑफ हीट। इन फ्लो ऑफ हीट वी विल सी दैट हीट ऑलवेज फ्लो फ्रॉम हॉट पार्ट ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट टू इट्स कोल्डर पार्ट, और वी कैन से फ्रॉम हायर टेम्परेचर एट द लोअर टेम्परेचर ऑफ द बॉडी। लेट फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ वी हैव सम कुक्ड फूड on the table that is very hot, after some time that food get cool. Why? Because the food was hot and the surrounding was cool. It means from high to lower it transfer heat, so the food transfer its heat to the cold surrounding and get cooled. So when it stop its transferring its heat, when both the surrounding and the food have equal temperature. If we have two things and both have same temperature, then there will not be any flow of or transfer of heat. For example, we have water that is about 50 degree centigrade, and we also have an iron piece that is heated up to 50 degree centigrade. If we put this iron piece in the water, there will not be any transfer of heat as both the things have same temperature. Heat can be transferred from hot to cold object by three means. One is by conduction, then by convection, and by radiation. First of all, we will take by conduction, the transfer of heat by conduction. How it take place? Actually, it take place in all the things like solid, liquid, and gases. But in solid, its transfer is the fastest. Then first of all, what is conduction? The transfer of heat from hotter part of a material to its colder part. Means in single thing, if we heat it from here, the heat is transferred from this hotter part to its colder part. How it take place, I will tell you. Here is an example. Suppose six students are sitting here, and the first one having a piece of chocolate. He have to transfer its piece of chocolate to the last one without any movement. What he will do? He transfer his piece of chocolate to him, then to next, then to next, and then to next, then to last. Without the movement, the transfer of chocolate take place to the last student. In the same manner, the heat is transferred from one end to another without the movement of the material as whole. For more clarity, we will see that in solids, actually it takes place fastest in the solids. So in solids, what happen? Here the molecules are closely packed. When we heat the one end of the, or at one side of the solid material, what happens? The molecules of the solid substance start vibrating. और जब इनके अंदर vibration start होगी, तो ये जो vibration के साथ जो neighboring molecules हैं, उनके अंदर भी vibration start हो जाएगी. और इस तरह से इनके अंदर काइनेटिक एनर्जी प्रोड्यूस होगी. काइनेटिक एनर्जी क्या होती है? एनर्जी ड्यू टू मोशन. अब ये वाइब्रेशन के साथ जो मोशन है, इसके साथ जो हीट जो है, इस तरह से आगे को ट्रांसफर हो जाएगी. लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड इट विद बाय डूइंग दिस एक्टिविटी. इसके लिए हम क्या करेंगे? वी विल टेक अ पीस ऑफ आयरन रॉड एंड फिट इट विद अ स्टैंड, and on it we will fit some nails with the help of wax. What we do, we will start heating its first end. And as I have told you that in conduction, the heat is transferred from one end to another without the movement of the material as whole. So it means if we heat it, the heat start transferring from here. So how we will see? When we heat it, the first nail dropped first. What does it show? It means heat is moving forward. Then next nail will drop. It means heat is moving forward. Then if we keep on heating, then next this will drop, then this will drop, and this will drop. This activity shows us that conduction of heat take place here from hotter end to the colder end. सबसे पहले ये जो हॉट एंड है ये गर्म हुआ और इसने अपनी हीट जो है आगे वाले मॉलिक्यूल्स को ट्रांसफर की और आगे वाले ने आगे वाले को, तो इस तरह से ये लास्ट वाले एंड तक चले गए. तो इज इट क्लियर? सो कंडीशन क्या है कंडक्शन के लिए? द टू ऑब्जेक्ट शुड बी इन कॉन्टेक्ट. हियर टू ऑब्जेक्ट शुड बी इन कॉन्टेक्ट. Then the temperature of the two objects should not be the same. As I have told you earlier that transfer of heat only take place when the transfer difference is the heat difference is there. If the temperature is same, then there will not be any transfer of heat. So there are some substances which are good conductor of heat. And what are good conductor of heat? Which allow heat to pass through them. And there are bad conductor of heat also. We also call them insulator. And they do not allow heat to transfer through them. This you have done in 6th standard also. So metals, all the metals are good conductor of heat. Whereas plastic, cotton, so many things are of a bad conductor. So here in this activity, you can do this yourself and find which are conductor and which are bad conductor. The liquids are bad conductor of heat. Let us see that water is a bad conductor of heat. How? What will we do in this activity? We will take a test tube half filled with water and we also take a piece of ice that is wrapped in copper wire gauze. What we do? We will start heating the test tube and water start boiling in it. When water start boiling, the ice in the wire gauze do not melt. It show that water is the poor conductor of heat. Now, what are the uses of good conductor of heat? As I have told you that all the metals are good conductors, so the cooking utensils are mostly made of metals. The best good conductor example is silver. After silver, there is copper. You have seen so many times the bases of the vessels are polished with copper so that heat can conduct easily through the container and help in cooking fast. Next, copper. The coils made of copper in refrigerator and air conditions also conduct heat away from them. Then we have also done mercury, which is a liquid metal filled in the thermometer, also conduct body heat or the object heat from object and tell us the reading. These are the application of the conductors. Now let's move to the bad conductors. The handles of cooking utensils are made of bad conductor objects. Then the heat do not reach up to our hand, and we are safe, and or we can say safe for safely cooking we use them. If we want to keep ice for long time, then we can cover it with jute or sawdust, as both the things are bad conductor of heat and ice do not melt in them. Next, in winter we wear woolen clothes. Actually, the woolen clothes have air spaces in between them. In these air spaces, air can trap, and air is the bad conductor of heat. So the body heat do not escape and we feel warm. Eskimos live in igloos. Igloos are hot from inside because the snow can trap a lot of air, and air is the bad conductor or insulator, so the heat do not pass out and igloo remain warm from inside. So these are the application of insulators or bad conductors and also of good conductors. I hope you understand the topic, and the rest of the transfer of heat we will do in our next session. And do reading of page number 58 and 59. Thank you.